Hallo zusammen. Today I'm gonna be reacting to American football player Nalf and his brother's first day in Germany. A new video on his channel, so feel free to check it out. You can find the link in the end card and of course also in the video description. I'm not gonna react to the entire video because you're supposed to watch the rest of it on his channel, of course. You should have an incentive to do so. Just before we're gonna start, some background for you guys. I'm a German native speaker and language teacher here on YouTube. I make videos about the German language and culture, and I react to certain things that foreigners, for instance Americans and others, might experience in Germany and when speaking German. So let's go for it.
It's gonna be cool. Yeah. Monday afternoon, Portland, Oregon.
Tuesday, Schwäbisch.
You know, it's such a simple cut, but I like the editing of Nalf's videos a lot. He does a great job pretty much composing his vlogs in a certain visual way, and that is what I just appreciate. Nalf is a cool guy. I've reacted to one of his videos before, which was about the German schooling system and differences to the schooling system in the USA, for instance. By the way, I've never been to Schwäbisch Hall, which is in southern Germany, but something that is pretty typical and common for many German towns, those houses are called das Fachwerkhaus, the half-timbered houses. Those are really common in older parts of towns and, you know, for instance, where I live in the Sauerland region, we also have those. They are really beautiful and they are pretty common. That's definitely typical.
All right, we just landed in Seattle for our layover.
Germany is crazy.
Mike, this is Seattle.
Love it.
And then the big flight, Seattle to Frankfurt.
That's the typical American pronunciation of the term Frankfurt, or the town, that is. It's legit because when you're American, you pronounce things the American way, and that is totally all right. By the way, from my German perspective, it's interesting that certain German towns and cities have anglicized forms or variations. For instance, instead of Köln, or, you know, just say Köln or something like that, it's Cologne in English. And the same is true for München, which is Munich in English. So maybe it has to do with the Umlaute, der Umlaut, Singular, die Umlaute, Plural. But for instance, in terms of Frankfurt, it just gets anglicized, Americanized. Frankfurt.
Pepe has picked us up, and now we're gonna drive back to Schwäbisch Hall.
I guess Schwäbisch Hall, as a town name, might be one of the most difficult ones to pronounce for foreign speakers, because of the Schw combination and the German W, W, Schwäbisch Hall.
Schwäbisch Hall.
That is pretty much spot on. But you know, when you pronounce certain terms with an A, it's not like the more English Hall, like an A type of sound. We don't really have that in German. Apart from that, spot on.
Try and open the German window. Oh.
I'm not an idiot.
Oh.
I know how windows work.
Okay, wait. Try and do it. Put it off kip.
Okay.
Nope.
Close. Nalf said a term that is really common in German, which is auf kipp. That basically means just opening the window slightly so that it's tilting a bit. That is pretty much what we mean when we say ein Fenster auf kipp machen, or auf kipp öffnen. It's das Fenster, singular, die Fenster, plural, the window. I don't know if that isn't possible in the US. I guess windows might be constructed a bit different there. I've never been to the US yet, so I don't know for sure. I guess we love having windows open auf kipp, because we can, I guess.
Make it go auf kipp. Now push
Tell
the hand.
Me what that means in English.
It means auf kipp.
The number one most important thing in Germany is learn how to put a Fenster auf kipp.
Then I took Mikey to get some groceries.
Mikey's first time in a German grocery store.
So Mikey needs to get some eggs, and I know for a fact that he's gonna be appalled when he sees the eggs here at the store.
What's wrong with them?
You'll see.
They're not refrigerated?
Yeah, neither is the milk.
By the way, it's die Milch, the milk. And it's true, most of that usually doesn't get refrigerated at German grocery stores. The reason being that it's usually Haarmilch, die Haarmilch, meaning die haltbare Milch, the durable milk. That processed type of milk is usually durable for many weeks in a row without being cooled or without the need of being refrigerated.
They're gonna hatch.
their eggs are too warm, they're gonna hatch.
So about eggs not being refrigerated at German grocery stores, that has to do with them not getting cleaned or washed clean before they get transported to the grocery stores. And that actually leads to the cover of the egg being intact, and they can get stored unrefrigerated. Is that even a term? I don't know. By the way, quick life hack for you guys. If you have eggs at home and you don't know if they are still durable, put the egg in question into a glass filled with water. And if it actually swims at the top, don't eat it. But if it stays down at the bottom and doesn't move, doesn't, you know, rise up, you can still eat it. The more you know with German with Vlog Dave. You're welcome. Gern geschehen.
Okay, I'm about to give Mikey a little tour of downtown Schwäbisch Hall, and we're gonna have him eat a Jufka from the Döner store.
Just a quick difference here in terms of languages, because in German we say der Döner, which is kebab in English. But no matter what you call it, it's freaking delicious, let me tell you. And it's really popular in Germany, by the way. Hope you enjoyed this video, you learned something. I try to give my German perspective on things because for me as a German, it's always interesting to see or to learn more about the foreign perspective on my country, culture, language, whatever. If you did, feel free to let me know by leaving a like, by sharing the video with other people. That always helps a whole lot. And of course, you can also become a channel member if you want to. Check out the video description with many interesting links to my socials and support options. And of course, also subscribe to Nalf's channel because, as I said before, he's a great guy. I really like him a lot. And hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'm your Vlog Dave. Tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.